So, for all of you who are freelancers, who are getting into freelancing, who have gotten into freelancing, who are thinking about getting into freelancing, I assume you're doing it for a certain reason or a certain preliminary reason, let's say. And it can be, there are all different sorts of reasons, right? Certain people do it because they want to spend more time with their family. And so they want to be able to work from home and set their own hours, et cetera, et cetera. Other people want to live remotely and they want to be able to live anywhere they want in the world and be able to work from there. Other people just want to be able to set their own schedule, to choose their own clients. And very often it's a combination of all of these, right? You know, because who wouldn't like to do all of those things, right? And so it kind of really depends at what stage you are in life and you know, what's your most important thing right now. So this video is actually to all of you who, out of all those things I mentioned, places most importance, at least right now, on a remote lifestyle, on being able to live wherever you want in the world. And the only reason I say this is because that's how it's been for me for most of the time. I think right now I'm in the middle of transitioning over to wanting to spend more time with my family and being able just to dictate my schedule more, because I guess that's where I am in life. You know, my wife and I are kind of feeling more settled down, and we don't necessarily have that as much anymore. However, as many of you might know, I've mentioned this before, for the past like 6, 7 years, I've been traveling all over the place and living in different locations. I've lived in Taiwan, in Shanghai, in Korea, in where else? In Portland, in Atlanta, in DC, in Lucca in Tuscany, in Lugano in Switzerland, in I don't know, and you know, so anyway, all these places all over, and on three different continents, and it's been me and my wife. We've been, you know, just going and living in all these different places and experiencing it, and it's been awesome. It's been great, and it has been thanks to this freelance lifestyle, really. And this was always what drove me, and this is what pushed me, what motivated me to try to make it work and make it work out. So this video is for all of you who right now are trying to live this remote lifestyle so you can live wherever you want in the world. And even if you're not there at this moment, which you know, I'm gonna assume you're not, I'm gonna assume you're kind of building towards that. And that's why you kind of want to build up your freelancing career to do something along those lines. This is my advice to you right now. Even though you can't travel right now, this is what you should be doing right now. So first of all, the first thing I think you should do is to plan it all out. And I understand you can't travel yet, but it doesn't matter. Think about where you want to go, where you would like to live most, or at least where you would like to start it out, right? And then plan out your stay there from start to finish. Go through housing, go through the transportation, go through you know, and then that means just being like going to Google and finding, looking at the different neighborhoods and seeing what, if you prefer this one to that one, where would be the, you know, best housing? Go to Google Street View, see what you like, and try to explore that neighborhood, and yeah, then find some coffee shops, find good restaurants you'll be visiting while you're there, and what type of food you have, and what you'll be going to see, and yeah, you know, where you'll be going from there. And along those lines, by the way, I think you should also look up other things to do. Plan out trips, day trips that you'll take from there, say road trips that you'll take. If your base is in Berlin, then maybe you can take road trips to other places in the area. Or if you're in Bolivia, you can, you know, do that. It really, you know, from wherever you are, plan out other things, and then look up classes. Now, I should say all these things I'm mentioning, I've made a course, and I have a course online that I teach you how to move and live abroad. And so I'm kind of getting some ideas from that. I'm obviously not going through the whole course, but this is just what I want you to do at the beginning. Actually, I don't even mention this in the course, because there I assume you already are trying to plan it out. But so anyway, but they are more or less a couple of the same ideas that I get from there. And one of the things I mentioned there is that anytime you move to a new place, you should always take classes. And you know, this is good because if you don't speak the language of the place, then it's the best way to learn the language to take a class while you're there. If you already do speak the language, if you're a freelance translator, maybe you already do, then you have even more classes you can choose because you can take it with the locals, and it's a great way to meet locals. You know, night classes, afternoon classes, weekend classes, whatever it is. And in fact, every time we travel to a new place, my wife, she'd always look up yoga classes there. And so she took yoga classes in, you know, Shanghai, in Tuscany, in the States. And you know, she doesn't speak all those languages, but she was still able to take yoga class. And many times she was more in tune with what was going on in our town and our city, thanks to the classes she was taking, because, you know, it gave her a group of local friends to hang out with. So that's what I want you to plan out as well. You know, look at what classes you're, are you going to take art classes? Are you going to take language classes? You know, are you going to take photography classes, yoga classes, sports, you know, whatever it is, look those up too. And then another thing I like to do when I go to a new place is I like a bit more before, but you know, still kind of now I'm into jogging. And so I look for the nearest body of water, because to me, once you find a body of water, you can jog along it. And so wherever I was, I looked for the nearest body of water and then try to jog along it. And it, for me, it was a great way to explore this new town and this new city. So I want you to do that as well. Basically, you're planning this whole shebang. So why are you doing this? Why are you planning it if you can't go anyway? It's because I want you to have a firmer idea in mind, if this is what's motivating you. And it's something you're going to enjoy doing anyway. You're going to enjoy looking this stuff up and, you know, daydreaming about where you'll be going, where you'll be hanging out and doing all this other stuff. So once you do all that, in fact, I almost want to make two videos because I want you to do that first. Take your time with it. Have fun with it and see what you can explore, what you can do, where you'll be going. Look up the restaurants and what you'll order there, the coffee shops, the bars, this, that, and the other. Anyway, have fun with all that as much as you like. Then comes the next step. Then I want you to try a couple of things. First of all, you're a freelancer, right? And so if you're a freelance translator, then maybe there are other freelancers or other people who need things in the city you're going to. And maybe there's some guy who designs websites in the city you're going to. And maybe that person will let you crash on their couch if you offer to translate all their websites for free. Or maybe you can do some deal where someone has a business and you can translate all their stuff for free, and in exchange they let you crash on a couch there for two weeks, you know, something along those lines. Because then it gets the gears going. Maybe you could do all the translations before you leave, and once you get there you have 2 weeks to explore the city and maybe see if you can get something else going, you know, and it gives you some breathing time. And then I want you to look in, so that's first thing. Have it in the back of my mind, or your mind as well, how you can exchange your what you offer, your business, your freelance business, for either housing or something along those lines. Another thing is, you're living someplace now, I assume. Is this a place that you can put up on Airbnb? If this is a place you're paying rent on, I mean, or mortgage, or, you know, that's costing you money, is this a place you can maybe put up on Airbnb? Because that's what we did with an apartment of ours. In fact, we didn't even know it was a possibility, because this is in a town, Lugano, Switzerland, a small town in Switzerland, but they do have Airbnb there. Not only that, we found a company that manages your Airbnb. Because the next step, once you find Airbnb, you kind of want a friend or someone who's there just in case things go wrong, or, you know, they need someone to clean in between people staying and all that. And in the town of Lugano, they actually have a service that does this. That does it, you know, a management service for Airbnb that does it professionally. So if they have it in Lugano, they probably have it in your town, wherever it is. So Airbnb could be a possibility, in which case you won't have to worry so much about rent. In fact, maybe you could be making some money while you're in the new place. Also, maybe you have a car. If you have a car, maybe you can loan it to someone for a small fee. Maybe you have someone who doesn't have a car. You'd be like, look, you can use my car. Say for 50 bucks a week, I don't know, you know, a couple hundred a month or whatever it is, you know, something kind of nominal, and which will be definitely cheaper than them renting another car. But at least you get a little something from it. And also your car isn't just sitting there idle collecting dust, which is bad for it anyway. Or if you're really intent on moving, maybe you could sell your car. I'm not saying you have to do it yet, but look up prices that you could get for it and something along those lines. What else do you have where you are right now? Well, you know, you have housing, you have transportation, so you might have a car. You also have possessions. So possessions are something else. You could put them in storage, but chances are you could probably sell some of them for some decent cash as well that could go towards your travel. Maybe you have a bunch of books. I'm not going to sell these, but, you know, if I did need more cash, I could probably look into selling some of them. Actually, I have another stack of books there on the ground that I am selling, because I know I'm not going to read them, I'm not going to use them, and so why not try to sell them? Some of them are new too. So look into stuff you have in the basement or in other places that maybe you can sell, and if you can get some extra cash for your travels that way. All this, remember, is still hypothetical. You're just playing around with this and maybe go on Excel to run some numbers to see, just have fun with it is what I'm saying. But maybe you don't have any of these things. Maybe you can't put your place up on Airbnb, you don't have a car to sell, you don't have possessions to get rid of. Then I want you to do a bit more of exercise while you have Excel there open. Figure out how much you would need to be making per month for this to work. If you're moving to Berlin or Buenos Aires or wherever it might be, how much would it cost per month? You know, you've been looking at housing, at apartments, you've been looking at, you know, where you want to travel, at the coffee shops and all that. Get an idea of a budget per month. And maybe before leaving, how much do you need to save? Because you need the airplane ticket there and, you know, there's some costs associated with moving in the first place. So how much would you need? Maybe you realize that you'd need, I don't know what it would be per month. Maybe $800 a month once you're there. And to get there, you'll need another $800, right? So it's $800 plus $800 a month. And so you're like, okay, I need to save $800 and then I need to find a way to be earning $800 a month. Then that is your new goal, if that's the case. Because now you're trying to get your freelancing career going and now suddenly you have a goal of what you need to make. You need to be making $800 a month. Because once you make $800 a month, then you're golden. At that point, you can travel to wherever you want, or, you know, assuming that $800 a month is what it comes out to. And a lot of these places, by the way, that's why I'm telling you to look up the prices and all that, because many times you're going to be surprised. A lot of times you're in the center city, you don't need a car at all. And you can get everywhere you need, at least at the beginning with public transportation, and then figure it out. Many times, a lot of these housing opportunities there are, I mean, they're pretty affordable and they're pretty good. So look into this. In fact, when I say $800 a month, this is probably on the high side. I think in all of the places we lived, that I lived with my wife, there was only one place that cost us more than $800 a month. And that was the one in Tuscany. I think, I might be wrong, I need to go through the numbers, but I don't think any other place cost us as much as $800 a month. So definitely look into what the price would be per month. And then that's your goal. That's how much you need to make per month from your freelancing career. And now that you have this more concrete goal, it'll give you something to shoot for. And it seems a lot more attainable that way, rather than I need to make a living from freelancing. No, you're like, I need to make $800, $600, whatever it is per month from freelancing. Anyway, this set goal, which very often isn't nearly as much as you were afraid it would be, can often be enough to get the gears turning and actually make this remote lifestyle thing, living abroad thing, a reality. And so this is just something that I recommend because, again, I've been spending the last few years doing this, living in all these different places, and it really is a question of, you know, taking these concrete steps. And so many of them are just so much fun. Like, my wife and I would love doing that, you know, trying to research, looking into new places and all that. And it starts off as just, whoa, wouldn't it be nice if, and slowly, slowly, slowly becomes reality. And that's what I want you to do now, to do this process and to try to see if slowly, slowly, slowly you can make this a reality for yourself. So let me know how that goes. Definitely let me know how that goes. You know, if you're able to do this and if something is able to work out, definitely let me know. And otherwise I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to like this if you do, and see you next time. Thanks, bye.